The slip out has drawn attention to natural hazards that exist along the Big Sur coastline.
Researchers at the US Geological Survey are now in response mode, analyzing data to understand exactly what caused the slip out and if there is a greater underlying threat. Here's Action News 8 reporter Brisa Colon live in Santa Cruz with more.
That's right, Dan and Aaron. Researchers at USGS Santa Cruz are currently processing all of the data that they've collected on the Rocky Creek slipout to ultimately share that with agencies from around the state.
Scientists at the US Geological Survey are constantly monitoring the ever-changing Big Sur coastline, focusing on natural hazards from landslides, road slipouts, and rock falls.
We're always working when it gets nasty, right? So when it's raining, when we've had those wildfires and the debris flows afterwards, we're getting up in the air as soon as we can, collecting the information, processing, and providing that information to the public.
Following the Rocky Creek slip out, John Warwick and his team immediately began analyzing the landscape, flying an aircraft with special cameras to document the changes. They bring that data back to the lab and then transfer it into 3D maps.
We can process really large data sets. And so when we fly the Big Sur coast, we take 4,000 or 5,000 photographs, all of which are tens of megabytes. And we can process all of those within about 12 to 24 hours.
Recent wetter winters and larger waves creating more movement. Warwick says in the case of the slipout, undercutting waves caused the road to crumble.
What we see, especially in Big Sur, is that these changes occur, these landslides occur during wet years and during years with bigger waves, or when waves are attacking the coast, you know, and delivering that energy right at the base of the cliff.
Their critical work helps to understand how large problem areas really are, ultimately saving lives.
If you compare the two maps, you can see there's some subtle movements in the slopes, and then those movements are then mapped with these colors.
Like back in 2017, when Mud Creek slid, USGS was able to use imagery to see it coming.
Caltrans closed the road and pulled the equipment off the road. So a big success story in us all contributing to understanding how big that slide was going to be and getting out of its way.
And again, John and his team are still awaiting on the finalized data set on the Rocky Creek slipout. But once they have that, they plan to share it with agencies like Caltrans so they can really understand just how stable or unstable the landscape is at this point. Reporting from Santa Cruz, I'm Brisa Colon, KSPW Action News 8.
Thank you, Brisa.